Luana Rubin from Equilter.com. I'm here at the 2016 International Quilt Festival, and I'm here with Susan Carlson, who has her own exhibit. And we're here to learn more from Susan about her work and how does she do that. So tell us a little bit about this exhibit and your work.
All right, well, the exhibit is entitled Specimens, and it's a collection of 11 of my quilts that are specimens of the animals, for the most part, of what they represent. Mm-hmm. And it's a fabric collage that I do, a fabric collage method, where I cut and glue, essentially.
Oh. So what kind of glue do you use?
I use Aileen's Tacky Glue.
Oh, okay.
Yes, it's a very simple white glue. It's a very simple method. It's kind of taking you back to cut and paste. Times when things were maybe a little simpler.
Yeah.
And it's a very fun method, it's a very freeing method, and it's something I've been doing now for about 30 some years.
Wow. Well, let's go look at a couple of your previous pieces.
Okay, all right.
Susan, I know this is a very popular piece and it's so eye-catching. Is there a story behind this?
Yes, it's entitled Tickled Pink, and it's based on a woodblock print by Albrecht Dürer, who was a 15th century artist in Germany. Mm-hmm. And I've loved his woodblock print. Of course, it was black and white, but I had it in mind that it needed to be pink. And so it makes people very happy, and that's you know, kind of fun. The impetus for getting it out of my head, I was thinking about it for probably at least a couple of years and collecting the fabric for it. Mm-hmm. And the impetus for getting it out and doing it was a K Facet exhibit. And so the quilts had to have some of his pieces, some of his work in it. Mm-hmm. And so I was, you know, of course it's got great florals and things like that. And so I started cutting them up, rearranging them, and it worked really well for this piece.
I would say
Yeah, made some good armor.
Yeah.
Floral armor.
Susan, this is one of my favorite pieces, really my beloved pieces, and I remember when I first saw it, I was just dazzled. I love the Australian fabrics, and I think it won a prize, right?
It did. It was just a return visit for this quilt to Houston. Mm. It was here 5 years ago, and it won the first place in the special exhibit Good For You.
Mm, great. Mm. And just tell me, how did you end up making this piece? There's got to be a story behind it.
Yeah, it's a portrait of our dog Pippin, who is what was called a Dixie Dingo. She was a rescue dog from the South up and came up to us in Maine. Mm-hmm. But the title, the term Dixie Dingo, really intrigued me. And with the dingo reference, I had already started collecting a few Aboriginal Australian fabrics. Mm-hmm. And I thought, oh, that would be perfect. Make her a portrait of her in all Aboriginal fabrics.
Yeah.
And that's what I ended up doing.
Well, very successful, I would say.
Thanks. Yeah. Thanks. She seemed to like it.
Yeah. Hey, this is one of my favorite pieces too, and there seems to be an Asian aesthetic with the indigo batiks. Can you tell us a little bit about this piece and also a little bit more about your technique and how you stitch these together?
All right, yeah. This piece is entitled Gombesa, and it's a coelacanth, which it's a real fish. It's life-size, thought to have gone extinct, but it was kind of rediscovered in 1938, so it has kind of an interesting history to it.
Oh, yeah.
And it lives in on either side of the Indian Ocean. So it lives in Indonesia. And that's hence the Indonesian batiks that are in it.
Okay.
It's also found off Madagascar, which is over towards Africa. And so it has an African cloth behind it.
Wow.
So it kind of, the fabric selection puts the fish in its place in the world.
Oh, wow. I love that.
Thanks.
So tell us how you stitch these together.
Yeah, well, I said earlier, it's a collage process.
Right.
So in this case, the fish is the collage part. And I took all the different fabrics, cut them into kind of palm-sized shapes, and then start to arrange them so that one blends into the next. Mm-hmm. And I can create highlights and shadows in that way by picking the light and dark values out of the fabrics.
Okay, cool. Well, let's go see your big piece now.
Okay.
Susan, this quilt is obviously the star of this show. everybody who walks past this goes, wow, how did she do that? And this is a crocodile, right?
Yes, it's a crocodile entitled Crocodilus Smilus. Mm-hmm. It's a full-size rendition of a saltwater crocodile, which are native to Australia, hence the Australian fabrics that you happen to yes. notice and we all love, right?
Yes. Uh-huh.
I had it in my mind to make it full-size just to show people the awesomeness of the animal. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of nice that it is getting attention because I think it makes people more aware of the animals and even all the animals in my exhibit. That's one of the ideas I have. So it's done in the same way. It's a fabric collage where I'm cutting out all different fabrics. And for me, not just the Aboriginal fabrics, but also large florals and batiks also said crocodile to me for some reason. It's a she. Her name is Stevie.
Oh, okay.
Yep. named in honor of Steve Irwin, who was the crocodile hunter of Australia.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah. So that's kind of her history. Mm-hmm. Kind of inspired by things that my son liked when he was about 3 or 4 years old, too.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
And we want to hear also just like how did you do it? I know that you've sewn on a home Bernina on your
yes.
other pieces.
Yes, I have. It was everything else except this one was quilted on my home Bernina. Mm-hmm. Yep, a wonderful workhorse that I've just had for years. I love it. This one though was a little bit challenging for that. So this one is done on a long arm.
Mm-hmm. So you mentioned before that you have glued the pieces down, so tell us about
yes.
how you stitch them afterwards.
Okay, yeah, so it's all glued onto the foundation, all these pieces, and then that secures everything until I'm ready for quilting. Mm-hmm. And then I set it up for quilting and do a free motion, kind of a stipple pattern across the whole thing.
Okay.
So there's, other than that there's no other stitching involved.
Were you terrified when you started to quilt this?
A little bit.
Yeah.
Being the first time on a long arm.
Oh, right.
Yeah, but it worked out fine. I was being tutored and I rented some time.
Oh, okay.
The woman was great in helping me get used to it. But it was kind of, it was fun. It was all part of the process. It's all part of a learning thing.
Yeah. And then didn't it premiere in Australia?
It did. Yeah, she traveled. Oh, no, she didn't premiere. It premiered down in, or up in Wisconsin at the Wisconsin Museum of Quilts and Fiber Arts. Yep. But then she did travel a few months later to Australia, which was pretty cool. And down in Melbourne at the Australasian Quilt Convention.
Right. Yep. I've been there. The building is beautiful.
Oh, it was just amazing. To see her in that building was just very fun and very satisfying.
Well, I followed your blog. I followed you online as you were making this, so it's a thrill for me to see this in person now, and I congratulate you. This is really an accomplishment.
Yeah, and to have this as part of the whole show is just great.
It's awesome.
Yeah, it's something
you
I've been
are
wanting
awesome.
To do. Oh,
yes.
Thanks. Thank you so much.
Well, Susan, thank you so much for your time and telling us about your work. And we'll see you again in the future. Can't wait to see the next bigger piece you make.
Oh, yeah, we'll see about that.
Okay.
Thank you.